among women. Every year, this program is getting more shape. And thank you, madame, for your great work. You and your team, which is a fantastic team. And I want to welcome here the godfather. This is the team, and you like the team. You were for me out there. So I'm happy. Great. So he is part of this big, I would say, memorial of modern lives around the world that still believe in Lebanon. And if you are here today yourself, it's because you are like us. You feel that you belong to this land. Otherwise, you wouldn't have made this trip. And I want to tell you that we're getting a rare species. We're becoming a rare species. People that believe that this country is ours, and we need to stay in this part of the world. This is why we have double. I am this year feeling more and more how important is our mission. Mission to stay in the world that we belong to this part of the world. Yet we are citizens of the world, and this is really the biggest challenge that not us only, but the whole civilization is getting to learn how to deal with the issue of managing different identities. Don't believe that you are living something special. This is a new trend. You need to know how to manage those new ambiguities in life. It's part of evolution. You are a citizen of the world. You are a Mexican or Argentinian or French or Canadian or American. But you are also Chinese. And you can have ideas of the world that are not even something that you learn from your parents or from your school or from your, you might develop your own concepts. And this is why, this is the beauty of diversity. Being Maronites from Lebanon, living all around the world, we had to deal with this kind of challenges very long time. So we are exceptionally well fit for the new world that's coming. We believe at Maronite Foundation that our duty is to say to our children and to you that living without a mission is an empty life. I want you to know this. If you made the whole trip to Lebanon and you come back without feeling this, this means that we have lost. You have wasted your life, and we did not succeed in our mission. I want to tell you that life is really not worth living without a mission. Eating, drinking, partying, even working. Living like this is a sort of a vegetative life. It is a vegetative life. You are taking calories, you are consuming them, and you are at the end dying. This is not what human beings are called for. Because we are all living in such an environment, we do not believe ourselves, we do not believe that it is a coincidence. We do not believe in coincidence ourselves, the World Bank Foundation. We believe in providence. It's a whole difference. So because of that, we felt that our mission is to dig deep and decide to stay. But stay with the mission. What is the mission? The mission is that the values that we are carrying should grow. What are our values? Our values is the values that we have learned from our father and grandfather that were developed and distilled, I would say, by events in history. What is it? distillation of the Maronites throughout the years. They have learned a lot of things. Most importantly, is that hard work. Hard work is essential. And two, open-mindedness is very important. Three, managing diversity is at the heart of our challenges. So having those three together, made out of the Maronites, an exceptional people in traveling, adapting, and succeeding. So we wanted to have this, if you want, have a home. Because if you don't know what you're doing, this can become people scattered all around the world without a home. Not all around the country, but a home. And Lebanon is what we are thinking of. This is what our grandfathers and fathers thought and fought for. And we feel that this Lebanon, the Lebanon that was designed, is a normal evolution of history. It's a normal evolution of history. Anyway, this Lebanon that was supposed to be the dream of our fathers and grandfathers, I would call them the founding fathers of Lebanon, is vanishing. It's a fact of life. It's vanishing. Why it's vanishing? Because this, combination of people and thoughts is going to one direction, one color. It's losing a major component. The Maronites are leaving Lebanon. And the Maronites, when they leave Lebanon, not only we are talking about leaving the Maronites, but we are talking about a major equilibrium of Lebanon will be changing. And this is the challenge. In the name of diversity, we need to succeed this experiment. This experiment that was started, in, I would say, in 18, at least, I would like to go back to Fakhreddin. You know Fakhreddin. But people would say, let's go back to the Mount Lebanon story. The Mount Lebanon story, which is after 1862. After 1862, we had the Lebanon that we are looking at today was preconceived, if you want, in 1862, after the war of the mountains between the Druze and the Maronites, and we decided to live together, Maronite and Druze, in coexistence, in pure, in a concept of a quota and power sharing ahead of time. This is the beauty of it. Irrespective of people, of quantities of people, of inhabitants, and we're going to create a democracy. And that was the first real democracy of all the Middle East. We had 24 deputies, 12 Druze and 12 Maronites, that were elected by the people. And from that time, we had, at that time, the Sultan or the president of this Mount Lebanon. Had to be approved by a consensus of all the nations. At that time there were five nations. So imagine this evolved into the formula that we have, the formula of Lebanon, which is how to manage diversity in a creative way. Unlike managing diversity with what happened in other places where to manage diversity, they created uniformity. This is the whole challenge. This is the whole challenge that we are trying to overcome. How can we manage diversity yet keeping the diversity and metallurgy, if you want. It's the difference between alloys and composite structure, for those of you that know this. So when you put carbon with steel, with wood together, they create a structure, a composite. If you melt them all together and you make a new compound out of them, this is an alloy. What you are trying to do in Lebanon is to have a composite structure. It's complicated. It's difficult. Yet it's very enriching because it's preserving the identities and learning how to manage those identities with a bigger identity. This challenge is taking us back to where we started. How to manage diversity, yet protecting your identities. So this formula of Lebanon, that is in Lebanon today, in the Middle East, that is at risk. If we are able to have people that believe in it, but strongly believe in it, with a sense of mission, saying that this mission is mine, this mission will turn me into a happier person. Because I have a mission, I have brothers and sisters all around the world that contain things like me, and I have a home of God, a beacon that I can go back to. If we can reach such a network, we will succeed. The One Life Foundation will have succeeded. And I tell you, it seems we are. And good news. It seems we are succeeding. Because the last, I would say, promotions, the last, I think, 5 or 6, all those that came here went back as emissaries, as ambassadors to this idea. And they are all around. And we are all connected. And we want to grow this network. And guess what? We felt that the public political world of Lebanon is evolving in a completely different sphere than us. We said the next move is to bridge the gap. This is why we started to have people involved in politics, thinking like us. Saying to ourselves, we need to have bridgeheads in this administration. This is why we have foreign ministry. We have a lot of key positions which believes exactly like me. And the president himself. And then I would consider myself as a small thing in this, but the whole idea is that we need to have this idea of having a Lebanon that looks like us succeeding. I want to end with saying, how does this Lebanon look today and how it should look? Lebanon today is a symptom. It's not a productive. We have a problem with productivity. Lebanon is not anymore a professional. Lebanon today, the quality of life of the Lebanese is going down delicately. When you look at this, and you look at you, or you look at the Lebanese all around the world, I was yesterday at the airport with the Forbes magazine that was giving special recognition for successful Lebanese. I was exceptionally thrilled by seeing those fantastic movies. Professional, productive,
This is Lebanon that should become, and we can do it if we succeed in bringing back those ideas in the public realm. We will end up having a home connected with a huge network around the world that is saying that we are, yes, we have a home, and we are all around the world. This is the new level that we are leaving to offer. This is a mission of life. It's worthwhile to have a mission. This is before happiness, and we are inviting you to share this beautiful journey. Thank you very much.
Thank you.